So if you've noticed online, something that a lot of content creators have in their offices or studios is an RGB tube light. Now, some of them online, generally they go for $100, $200. They can go even higher than that. The one I've got there actually cost me $30 to make, or just under $30. And in this video, I'm actually going to show you the materials you need, going to break down the cost of all the materials, and I'm going to provide you links of where you can purchase everything. Not only that, is I'm actually building another tube light just like that one. So I'm going to document and show you the whole process from start to finish, how you can build yourself one at home. Now, this tube light is super lightweight, powered by USB. It's got a USB-A cable in there. So you can see I'm actually powering it through a power bank at the minute, which you can do. Makes it super portable. And it does all the stuff the other fancy light tubes do. So you can do a normal change of color if you want, or you can do random different effects, etc. So without further ado, let's build another tube light. And if you like these kind of videos, leave a like on the video down below and consider subscribing if you enjoy the video once you've watched it. So let's get started. So I'm going to try and make this video very simple. That way, the simpler it is, the easier it is for you to follow at home. I've got here a breakdown of cost and materials of what you're going to need. So first thing is, and the main thing I would say, a 1 meter RGB strip. The one I think you should definitely go for is the WS2812. 144 LEDs per meter, which makes for all these nice effects that you can do. Also, because the LEDs are so close together, it gives you a much more diffused look, and also it gives you a much brighter look. If we compare, this is the cheap kind of LED you'll find basically anywhere. You can see how small the LEDs are and how far apart they are. And we compare them to the 144 LEDs per meter. You can see how much larger the LEDs are on here and how much closer they are together. So a much, much better product. And it's not that much more expensive. I think this one is anywhere between $7 to $10. Next, to control the actual LED strip, you're going to want to get a LED receiver like this. So basically the LED strip plugs into one end and the other end is USB to plug into a power pool or power bank. And then this section here is your receiver, which allows you to connect to the app or use the remote control to change the colors, effects and whatnot. These receivers generally around $5. Now, I will say now that I've purchased many of this stuff on Temu, which gives me a very cheap price. However, you can get them from Amazon as well, and I will link both options in the description box below. Now, for the tube guard, this is the only one I could find, but it turned out working out perfectly fine. I did originally look for acrylic tubes, which might be a little bit cheaper, but this is a T8 tube guard. I think it's 1.2 meters in length. And for this LED strip, it's only 1 meter. So I actually had to cut this down a little bit because you don't want the dead zones in the ends with no light. It just doesn't look nice. And you get these caps on the end, but they are hollow. But I have found that if you just get a normal bottle cap, you can glue it or stick it on to the end and works perfectly fine. Some items like matte, this is the last item you're going to need, matte self-adhesive vinyl wrap. So a matte white adhesive vinyl wrap, this is for your diffusion. This is, we're going to basically wrap around the acrylic tube to give that diffused look and make it look nice. This is probably going to be the hardest part of the whole thing, wrapping it around, because you've got to get out all them bubbles and whatnot, but we'll get there. We'll get there. So the first step is grab your actual tube that you're going to use. And if you bought the LED strip that I showed you, it's probably around 1 meter long. You want to make sure that your tube light is not exactly 1 meter, but I guess it can be 1 meter, but ideally you want it to have like 1 or 2 centimeters on each end, because sometimes the caps you get will cover up the end and that will give you that uniform light all the way through without having dead spots on the end. So that's the first step. Once you've cut it to size, I mean, these are pretty thin, so you can just cut it with a knife with some serrated edge or something like that. Next step is probably going to be the hardest one out of the whole thing. Once you get this bit done, everything else is easy peasy. So you're going to get your vinyl wrap, and you might already know, if you've ever used vinyl wrap, it is a pain to put on because you want to make sure there's no bubbles, etc. Now this one is around 30 centimeters or 40 centimeters that way width. So instead of having three times rolling around your tube, because your tube is around 1 meter, what you want to do is pull it out to around 1 meter, 1 meter 5. It's easy to cut the ends off if you get it too long. and then cut it this way through the middle. That way you can wrap it around your tube as needed. Make sure don't overlap when you go around your tube, because I don't think it'll be too good, and one layer of this stuff is enough for the diffusion. So as you wrap it around, meet on one side of the tube. It's fine to have like half a centimeter of error, because on the back you can just put one strip of tape going from the top to the bottom. And then on the inside where that tape is, that's where you're going to stick the actual LED strip. So it doesn't really make a difference. I'll show you on my RGB strip that all around the tube is fine. And then once you get to one section, you can see I've got a piece of tape going from top to bottom. And on the inside, that's actually where the tube light is. That's where the RGB strip is taped to. So it doesn't make a difference. So don't worry too much about that. Again, when these tube lights are in the background, they're not usually very close to the camera, but when they're in the background, you'll never spot any kind of mistakes that you see. I mean, even my one, I'm sure if I get too close, I can spot some tiny mistakes with the vinyl, but from a distance, it looks perfectly fine. So don't worry about that too much. So now that you've got your vinyl wrap on there, don't worry if it's not perfect. Just like I said before, even my one has got a ton of like ripples and stuff in there. But once the LED is in there, you won't even notice it once it's on. So do not worry. Main thing is you did as good a job as you could. And then you can see mine doesn't go all the way to the end. But once I put the cap on, the cap covers it. So perfectly fine. In one of the bottle cap ends, you want to make a square, just like I've made here. I literally made this just with the knife I've got. Be careful though, because the plastic at the top is not very hard. So it was very easy to make that hole. And you only need to make the hole on one bottle cap. On the other bottle cap, it can remain complete. So like I said, for the sake of this video, I'm just going to use tape, whereas on the other LED tube I did use the glue gun to go all the way around. So I'm going to put the lid on top and just with tape going to go around and secure it, and there we go. So one bottle cap and done, easy peasy. And there we go, second end done as well with the hole in the bottom. So now we've got both our caps. We want to get the LED strip inside of the actual tube. And this is going to be difficult because if you peel off the adhesive on the LED strip, you really want to be careful to get it on the right side where that section is where we said of the two pits meeting. And if it does stick to the other end, it's going to be very difficult to take out. So here is a tip that I actually found out. So if you've got any of that vinyl paper or vinyl adhesive, the matte white stuff we used, cut off a section like this and fold it in half so it sticks to each end. And what we're going to do, we're going to stick this vinyl paper onto the back of the LED strip, and we're going to leave about 2 centimeters of it hanging out that's not stuck onto the LED strip. And I'm going to tell you exactly why in a minute. So let's stick this one on first. So there we go, that one's stuck on, and then we've got that section hanging out. And then we're going to do the same for the other side of the LED strip. So I'm going to have that little bit sticking out and stick the rest of it on to the LED strip. So it's going to look like this. You're going to have that section, like I said, 1-2 centimeters hanging off, and the rest of it is stuck on the LED strip. Do not take the adhesive off the rest of the LED strip. So leave that adhesive on. Doesn't really make a difference. It's going to be fine. So now what you're going to do is you're going to push the LED strip down into the actual tube. So we're going to get it all the way down to the end. Keep going, keep going, until it comes out the other end. So the section that goes into the actual receiver is the bit that's going to go through the cap with the hole in it. So I believe the female end of the LED strip matches with the male end of the receiver. So we're going to only put this section through the actual cap. Leave the two cables in there. They don't need to come out. So there we go. So that bit's in there. The other two cables you can just roll up and push into the cap. That doesn't really make a difference. And then we're basically, what we're going to do, we're going to align the LED strip with the bit we put there. This section of 2 centimeters that we left, we're going to fold it over. And then we're going to pull the cap down. And what that's going to do is that cap is going to actually go over that section. And it's going to stop it from moving, which is also going to make the LED strip stay in its place. So no need to tape down the whole LED strip. And if you ever need to change the LED strip later, easy to do so. So there we go. Now that's in there. And we're going to do the same for the other end. So here is the stuff. And for this one, we won't need the actual cable, so they can just go in there like that. And then we're going to get that paper. This one's a bit shorter on this end. Fold it over the edge. There we go. Put the cables in there. We can roll them up to a bunch. It's probably a bit easier. And then we're going to tear that as well. And now you've got your finished LED strip. So if we plug it in now, so this end is going to plug into here. Simple plug in. And now the other end is simply going to plug into a power bank. So I've got a power bank right here. And now I'll put this over my shoulder. You can see once I plug it into the power bank, it's working perfectly fine. And like I said, if you've got them little errors in the vinyl when you wrapped it around, they're not visible at all. Obviously on the back where I've put the tape, you might be able to see that tape section, but that's not going to be on camera. We're going to keep this bit on camera. So now you can have this in the background. You can download the app by scanning the QR code on the actual receiver, do all the little effects, change the colors and whatnot like that. And yeah, have your own LED or RGB light strip, tube light, whatever you want to call it, for under $30. If you have any questions about the RGB tube light that I just made, leave them down in the comments box below and I'll be sure to answer what I can. Links for all the stuff included in this video will be linked down below as well. So yeah, if you liked the video, give it a like, thumbs up, and if you want to see more content like this, subscribe to the channel. So thank you and I'll catch you on the next one.